In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform two-way ANOVA in R. Two-way ANOVA compares the means of more than two groups with two independent variables. In our previous example of one-way ANOVA, we were interested in whether the mean of weight loss is different among three different diet groups. Now, apart from diet group, we also want to know whether the gender would affect the weight loss. Our independent variables are the diet and the gender, and weight loss is our dependent variable. We first set the working directory, and then we load the data using read.csv, because our data is saved in a CSV file. If the data is not too big, we can view our data by clicking the data frame under the environment. There are 78 people with three different diets, diet 1, 2, and 3. Our dataset is balanced as we have 24 people with diet 1, 27 with diet 2, and 27 with diet 3. Their weight was recorded before and after the diet, and the weight loss was calculated already. We know their gender coded as 0 or 1, where 0 means female and 1 means male. We also have two missing values here coded as an A. We check our data structure by typing str. The weight loss is in the form of numeric, which is good. However, the diet and gender are integers, and we would like to have them both as factors. We use s.factor for the variable diet, and assign the factor to replace the original column diet. For the variable gender, we use the factor command to change the gender into factor and tell R the labels for gender. The NA values missing data will not be changed. Now we have our data ready. The next thing to do is to visualize our data. We are going to produce a mean plot with error bars for each diet group. However, we are going to use different color for gender. We will use the function ggline from the ggpopr package, so we need to install and load the package first. We use this function ggline to plot the figure on the right. We need to specify the data frame we are going to use, which is my_data. The x-axis is our variable diet, and the y-axis weight loss. We change the color by gender group. In order to add other elements to the plot, like the error bars and the point plots, we type add here and include two elements, mean SE and jitter, which gives a small amount of random variation to the location of each point. Then we specify the name for y-axis, weight loss, x-axis, diet type, and the legend title, gender. I also specify here that I want the legend to be on the right of the plot. Here, what we have is the mean plot with error bars for each diet. We use the default color palette in this package. The right dots and line are for female, and the blue dots and lines are for male. The two NA values are plotted in gray, and they are both from diet 2. It appears that the mean of weight loss is higher on average in type 3. Besides, we can tell from the plot that an interaction effect is needed for the two-way ANOVA because the blue line and the red line are not parallel and they cross each other. It shows that the mean of weight loss is different between males and females across the three diets. These differences of mean weight loss seems bigger for females. Then the next thing to do is to conduct a two-way ANOVA test. We call the function AOV, and we first type the continuous variable weight loss, a tilde, and the factor variable gender and diet. We also specify an interaction term between the variable gender and diet, and link them with a column. Then we specify where the data comes from. Alternatively, we can use a star to link the variable gender and diet, which include a main effect for gender, a main effect for diet, and an interaction effect. Let's run these two lines of code. They are actually the same. We will call the summary of the analysis using function summary. And res underscore AOV2 is where we saved the results of two-way ANOVA. Here is the output. This is the main effect for gender. This is the main effect for diet. And this is the interaction effect. The results show that there was a statistically significant interaction between the effects of diet and gender on weight loss, with p-value equals 0.0488. As you know that if the interaction term is not significant in your analysis, you should remove the interaction term in your code and only type the gender plus diet. In addition, the main effect of diet is also statistically significant with p-value equals 0.005, but the main effect of gender is not significant. It also shows that two observations deleted due to missingness, and this was done by R automatically when we used the AOV function. Before we can confirm the ANOVA result is valid, we need to check the assumptions of our two-way ANOVA. The two-way ANOVA test assumes that the data are normally distributed and the variance across groups are equal. We checked assumption with diagnostic plots. We first checked the homogeneity of variance assumption by plotting the residuals versus fitted values. Similar to what we did for one-way ANOVA, this object res underscore AOV2 is saved from conducting our two-way ANOVA analysis. And we specify 1 here in order to plot the residuals. We can see from the plot that the variance of our residuals are relatively equal across groups. There is no evident relationships between residuals and fitted values, so we can assume the homogeneity of variances. We can check this by conducting a Levine's test. We will use a function in the package car. So we first load the package. Then we use the function Levine test, and we type the weight loss, tilde, and the variable gender, a star, and diet. Also, we specify the data frame we are using. From the output, we can see that the p-value is not less than significance level of 0.05. This means that there is no evidence to suggest that the variance across groups is statistically significantly different. Again, we can assume the homogeneity of variances. Another assumption that we are going to check is the normality assumption. We test the normality of residuals by plotting a QQ plot. We type the plot function and specify 2 here. In the QQ plot, most of the points fall approximately along this reference line, although there are a few points that are away from this line. Then we run a Shapiro-Wilk test to see whether the residuals really follow a normal distribution. We first extract the residuals and save it into AOV underscore residuals. And then we type the Shapiro.test. We can see from the output that the p-value is 0.19, which is not less than the significance level of 0.05. This means that there is no evidence to suggest the violation of normality. Now, normality and homogeneity of variances have been checked, and assumptions are met for running a two-way ANOVA. We can conclude that there is statistically significant interaction between the effects of diet group and gender on weight loss. Next, we conduct post-hoc tests to see which pairs of diet groups are different. We are using the Turkey Onus Significant Differences test, Turkey HSD test, for multiple pairwise comparisons. We use the Turkey HSD function, and we type the saved results res underscore AOV2 from previous two-way ANOVA analysis. The output is quite long and contain information about different pairwise comparisons. When interpreting the Turkey HSD output, we only interpret the interaction if the interaction terms was previously shown as significant in the ANOVA test. If the interaction term was not significant, we shall then interpret the post-hoc test for the main effects that are significant. Since the interaction term was significant in this dataset, we go to find the output where interaction term is reported. In the output, there are 15 pairwise comparisons in total, including pairwise comparisons between males and females, and comparisons within females or males. However, there is no evidence to indicate a difference between diet type for males. For females, there are two pairwise comparisons that show statistically significant results. The comparison between diet 1 and diet 3 is significant for females, with a p-value equals 0.019. There's also significant results for diet 2 and diet 3 for females, with a p-value equals 0.004. The main differences tell us that the females on diet 3 lost on average of 3.27 kilograms more than those on diet 2, and 2.83 kilograms more than those on diet 1. So, this is a summary of how you would perform a two-way ANOVA in R.